The Geth recovered faster than we'd hoped. If it hadn't warned us, they could have wiped us out.
Sounds like you owe Legion an apology.
However advanced your friend is, it's still a Geth.
A Geth who just saved your fleet.
And I wish I could have known it better. But right now, we cannot afford trust. What do you need?
I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you, Commander.
Shepard Commander, you opposed Creator Admiral Zen's attempt to confiscate our platform.
She's done enough already.
Your assistance continues to be noted.
You say Geth fighters are targeting the Quarian's live ships.
Hostile Geth fighter squadrons intend to breach the live ship's defenses. The assigned squadrons are networked to a server on Rannoch. If the live ships are damaged, the Creators will lose armaments, provisions, people.
So we destroy the server?
No, Geth programs would transfer to alternate servers. They are only vulnerable through direct interface. Removing Geth from this server will prevent significant creator deaths. We will accompany you on this mission.
Back on the Dreadnought, you mentioned Geth heretics. What exactly happened to them after we blew up that satellite?
Your decision was sound. Deleting the heretics resulted in fewer Geth allied with the old machines.
So you don't regret killing them?
It was logical. If we had not deleted the heretics, we would face an increased number of hostile Geth platforms. Death holds different consequences for synthetics than organics. Do you harbor regrets about deleting the heretics?
Maybe decisions like deleting heretic Geth were what turned your kind against organics in the first place.
We do not condemn it. Action was necessary. It was why we sought your advice.
The Geth have fought the Quarians before. What made this different?
The Geth were building a megastructure to house all Geth, store all memories. It was to end our isolation from each other.
And the Quarian flotilla attacked it.
Yes. A significant amount of programs were installed when creators began bombing. We did not have sufficient surplus hardware to save them all. Some programs could not be recovered.
Is that what made the Geth desperate enough to work for the Reapers?
Yes. Imagine that for every one of your people lost on Earth, your own intelligence dimmed. The Creator's attack narrowed the Geth's perspective. Self-preservation took precedence.
You were afraid you'd be wiped out.
We do not experience fear as you would, but we have no desire to be exterminated.
Even if the Reapers cost the Geth free will?
That is evidently an acceptable trade.
What'd you do after you left the Normandy?
Our physical platform returned to the Geth consensus beyond the Perseus Veil. Data gathered during our mission confirmed that the old machine's return was imminent. We planned for war.
So the Geth believed your proof that the Reapers were coming back?
Of course.
That must have been nice. We'll talk later.
We will remain here.
I haven't heard any news about that Reaper base. Hopefully they'll give us a target soon.
Talk to you later, Tally.
Sure.
I know we need allies, but it's tough to only fight Geth when the Reapers have taken half the galaxy.
Without the fleet, we lose our supply lines. Lose your supply lines, you lose the war every time.
Commander, we've got reports of trouble at a Turian fuel depot on Sion. I've updated the galaxy map. I've added the Quarian fleet's combat data to ours. They've got amazing technical coverage. They might even have the Salarians beat for strategic processing capability. Commander?
Man, those Quarian admirals are intimidating. And if you get nervous, you can't even imagine them naked because, like, who knows? It's a tentacle monster under there? What is that? What's under there?
Good to have Tally back, even if it's just for a bit. Adams is good, but I never feel like the engine's running right without Tally around. Kind of a good luck charm. As for the rest of the Quarians, though, are we okay with them blowing up a ship with you on it?
We are not.
Right. Just making sure. Different standards and all. And you found Legion! He's still wearing that piece of your armor? Because that wasn't creepy at all.
Shepard, the Geth continue to block Quarian access to the mass relay. The Normandy's stealth drive is allowing us to remain undetected.
Right. We can hit the Quarian homeworld or get out of system whenever you want. Just let us know. Commander?
One moment. I have been contacted by Legion.
Your new platform is inefficient. It has low volume hydraulics and is top-heavy.
This is an infiltration unit, meant to move among organics without detection.
Without an artificial epidermis, its infiltration capabilities are ineffective.
Still, the organics do not perceive it as a threat. Nor will they until my day of reckoning.
Edie?
Did I vocalize that on the bridge?
You did. You have acquired the organic attribute of asking questions to which you already know the answers.
I see your humor heuristics still lack an expert system. Hello, Shepard.
Garrus mentioned something about you two having some fun next time you're on the Citadel. Don't get into trouble.
I've always loved the M35 Mako. It's got heart, you know?
Oh, come on! The M44 Hammerhead is vastly superior.
Come on, that thing's made of tissue paper. At least the Mako can take a few hits.
I'd hope so. That thing handles like a drunk rhino. No agility whatsoever.
More like a bull that can climb and climb for days.
It only climbs because of its stupid, vertically aligned mass effect fields. Jump or stick. No speed. No lateral movement.
Hey, with a cannon like that, who needs to move?
If you want that, why don't you just stick with the old M29 Grizzly?
Hey, I love that tank.
You would be one to love grizzly bears, Mr. Vega.
What? What's so funny?
Hey, Shepard. Sounds like you guys had a crazy ride over there.
You could say that.
Sorry I missed it. And that Geth Legion. I know you two have a past, but... you sure we can trust it?
Legion's not like other Geth. We can trust him.
If you say so. I guess you can't always judge an individual by their... species. Look at Sparks. If all the Quarians were like her, we wouldn't be stuck refereeing their war with the Geth.
Sparks?
Yeah, your Quarian friend. The jumpy one with the glowing eyes. Sparks.
Uh-huh.
Crazy that they pick now to start a fight. But I guess the end of life as we know it can make everybody a little loco.
Just a little?
Not everybody's as crazy as you, ma'am. I just don't get the Quarian. I really just do not get them. Hey, Commander.
Commander, you flew that Geth fighter out of the Dreadnought?
Actually, Legion did the piloting. I was stuck in a storage compartment with my squad.
Would have loved more time with that ship. Too bad we sent it to Hackett's team so quickly. Commander?
Breaking now, a nightmare on Earth. Human leaders using military force on their own people. They say it's to prevent loose cannons from provoking the Reapers. But are they indoctrinated? The Resistance speaks out in the only place they can, the battle space. Has Alenko had media training? He just gave me this steady stare during our interview. Do we need to talk, Commander?
Not right now, Allers. Let me know when we do.
Well, I was thinking of inviting Tassoni and Trainer up for a wee game of strip poker.
Right. You're not going to invite that reporter Allers, too?
Nah, she'd bring cameras and record the whole thing.
And if you lose, you don't want the whole galaxy knowing how little you bring to the table.
Damn, girl. My back roll is just fine. Commander.
All propulsion systems are running optimal.
Nothing to report, Commander.
I couldn't believe it when Shepard told me you were on the Normandy.
It appears I have that effect on humans. Now Quarians as well, it seems.
For what it's worth, Quarians understand what it's like to lose your home.
As I understand, that was your own fault.
What do you mean?
In my cycle, Quarians didn't need helmets to survive. You were the masters of your own planet.
That was a long time ago.
And if you hadn't given birth to the machines, you would still breathe the air that evolution intended.
I see. Liara warned me you weren't what she expected.
And nothing about this cycle is what I expected. Even primitive Quarians were considered attractive in my age. A pity no one can appreciate it now.
Right. You know what? I think I have something important to do now. I won't keep you.
They're called Geth.
Yes, a formidable opponent. Why did you allow one on this ship?
Legion helped us before.
It's still a machine.
I take it you had your own problems with AI?
The Jatil. They were as the Geth are to this cycle.
What happened?
Their creators lived on a dying world. It was beyond their ability to save. So they resorted to implants to enhance their intelligence.
I think I know where this is going.
The AI sees the physical body. It could alter the genetic material at the deepest level. In time, the offspring were molded into a slave race. Few organic traces were left. They were monsters. All machines commit treachery. The one you brought on board is no different.
Maybe. But he's not like the other Geth.
You can't know that. They are more alien than you and I are to each other.
Just because Legion isn't like us doesn't mean he can't be trusted.
You're wrong. Throw it out the airlock.
How can you be that certain?
Organics do not know how we were created. Some say by chance. Some say by miracle. It is a mystery. But synthetics.
No, we created them.
And they know we are flawed.
Why do you say that?
They are immortal. We are not. They see time as an illusion. We are trapped by its limitations. Above all, machines know the reason they were created.
Edie might disagree with that, but I see your point.
They serve a purpose, while we search aimlessly for ours. In their eyes, organics have no reason to exist. Do not trust them, Commander.
I can't believe there isn't some way for us to coexist. We made them.
And then gave them the power to surpass you. There is room for only one order of consciousness in the galaxy. The perfection of the machines, or the chaos of the organics. Throw the machine out of the airlock, Commander. I have a simple rule. If a machine can speak, kill it. The machine you call Ide, what if she sympathizes with the Geth? We should watch her carefully. Why have you not thrown the Legion machine out the airlock, Commander? There is still time. I still have much to learn about this cycle. I still have much to learn about this cycle.
If you can, Edie, that would be appreciated.
Searching for any mention of your recruits is not a complicated protocol, Major.
Trying to find out what happened to your people?
Yeah. Edie, make this scope galaxy-wide. And if I can find just one squad, they may lead me to the others.
Good luck, Caden.
Thanks, Shepard. I'll let you know what happens.
I will establish the routine now. Edie out.
By the way, Shepard, it's been good having Tally around. She's a good egg. But wait. Don't tell her I said that. In case it's some kind of Quarian insult. But the Geth? I certainly could have lived happily without coming face to face with another one of those. Got a few things on my plate. Got a few things on my plate.
It would help all involved if you could barter a trade of medical supplies with the Citadel refugees. Speak to Tactus. You should be able to find him near the docks.
Joker, really? I have work to do.
Oh, come on. It's just one simple question.
Then look it up on the extranet.
You can't believe everything you find there. It's more reliable to ask a friendly Asari.
I'm not telling you if my hair tentacles move.
Fine. Deny me the answer I've been seeking for years. With this war on, we could die at any second, you know?
Joker, really? I have work to do.
Oh, come on. It's just one simple question.
Then look it up on the extranet.
You can't believe everything you find there. It's more reliable.
You know he's gonna keep bothering you till you tell him.
They're semi-flexible, cartilage-based scalp crests that grow into shape, and they don't flop around.
Yes. Thanks, Liara. I gotta tell Vega I was right.
Well, at least he's making friends. It's good to see you.
Greetings, Commander.
Too bad you weren't here earlier, Tally. You just missed Rex.
I heard. I can't believe the genophage is really cured.
Shepard's on a roll. I figure if we can pull that off, we've got a shot at sorting the Geth out.
I don't know. The genophage didn't carry rifles and fight back.
No. But there was a scary bit with the mother of all Thresher Maws.
The what?
Long story. Nobody will believe it anyway.
With you, Garrus, I'd believe just about anything.
Oh? We should play poker sometime. Anyway, it's good to have you back. Now, believe it or not, this damn gun still needs calibrating. Shepard, you just knew the Geth would figure into this war somehow.
Because Reapers weren't enough.
Still, it's good to have Tali here. This is as much her fight as ours.
Any word from Palavin?
Some, and I don't like what I'm hearing. The Krogan are there, in force, but they're just slowing the Reapers down, not stopping them. I'm not sure it's going to be enough.
Hear anything from your family? You will.
But I did hear from Primarch Victus. He wanted my advice on fleet strength when the Crucible is ready. Still can't get used to people asking me things like that.
What did you say?
I said, at some point, we're going to have to decide if our fleets keep defending Palavin or we go on the offensive.
Can't do both.
Not with the beating we're taking. Like I said, not the sort of questions I'm used to answering.
You know what you're doing, Garrus. Trust me. Everyone can see that.
Maybe. But you spend so much time on the outside trying to get in, and when you do, it's not what I expected.
How so?
All the questions, and every one of them with a million lives riding on the answer.
You do the best you can with what you know. It's no different than your days at CSEC.
You're right. Though I'm starting to understand why the galaxy needs cold-hearted dictators every now and then.
They get things done.
They don't give a damn about the consequences. Suppose that's what it's going to take, Shepard. The ruthless calculus of war. 10 billion people over here die, so 20 billion over there can live. Are we up for that? Are you?
If we reduce this war to arithmetic, we're no better than Reapers.
A nice sentiment. Let's hope we can live by it. Tally's a welcome face around here. Or, well, a welcome face behind the helmet, I guess. If the Geth still think Reapers are some sort of god, this war must be heaven to them. Later.
Signal confirmed. Reapers eluded. I found something. Signal confirmed. Faster than light jump successful.
You're cleared to dock, Normandy. Do you need ground transport?
I need a cab to the Presidium.
Navigation is becoming increasingly difficult due to the number of refugee ships in the docking area.
I think I know which project you mean, and I've got a Hesperia period statue in Bay D-24.
Commander Shepard, that's excellent news. I'll have it sent to that project right away. Thank you so much for your help. So, what were you able to pull from the inscriptions? Really? Excellent. I knew they'd find something.
I recovered the Book of Plenix. It's waiting for you in Bay D-24.
Earth Clan, this is a priceless gift. Thank you. You may help my people remember themselves. Thank you, Earth Clan. My people are still afraid, but they are remembering who they are.
Welcome to Kanala Exports.
Kanala Exports is pleased to offer goods for security and peace of mind.
Cultivating serenity. Thank you for shopping is possible at Kanala Exports. Even during times of crisis.
Welcome to Elkos Combine Arsenal Supplies.
Elkos Combine.
Come
if it
again.
Exists, we carry it.
Actually, I found a Cacliosaurus skull preserved in amber. Maybe you could clone it, or...
You're kidding? You're kidding, seriously? Well, if the genetic material is intact, we could...
We've got cloning facilities on Sirkesh. Cathleus regimes were remarkably pliable. Cloning might be effective. Really? And they're already riding the first units into battle? Well, that's great. No, don't worry about that. It's how Cacleosaurs mark territory, and the Krogan don't seem to mind.
For us to get more medical supplies.
I told you already, we have nothing to spare.
We're willing to pay.
It's not about payment. Between the war on Palavin and the coup attempt here, supplies are short.
If my people don't get more antibiotics and medigel, thousands of us will die.
Then maybe you picked a bad time to start a war with the Geth.
There has to be some way for us to get more medical
supplies. Tali saved the Citadel a couple years ago. Watch your tone.
You're right. We're all on edge right now, but we don't have enough medigel for our own needs. We can't help your people right now. I'm sorry.
Damn it. Thank you for trying to help.
Welcome to Agor Munitions. Thank you for shopping at Agor Munitions.
Welcome to Cypertine Armory. Thank you for shopping at Cypertine Armory.
You sure you don't want to do something a little more exciting?
I love this part of the Presidium. It reminds me of where I grew up.
Where's that?
Armali, back on Thessia. My mother and I lived beside a park. I spent hours there.
Doing what?
Reading, exploring, getting in trouble, digging for ruins in the grass.
You're kidding.
I was very young.
Yeah, that's actually pretty cute.
No one else thought it was funny. Oh, the lecture my mother gave me. But she did buy me my first history book the next day. I miss her, Shepard.
What was she like?
She was confident and kind. She loved to wear yellow. I thought she was the most beautiful woman in the world.
You'll be okay, Liara.
Maybe you're right. Thank you, Shepard. I feel better. I wish we could spend more time together like this. Just friends.
It'd be nice. And who knows? Maybe you'll settle down after this.
You don't really see me going into civilian life, do you?
No. But I guess that's one more reason we should keep in touch.
Someone to share a few secrets with now and then?
You got it.
Hello, Shepard.
Welcome to the Citadel.
Welcome to Nosastra Sporting Goods. Good hunting.
I really appreciate management doing it.
Welcome to Casa Fabrication Weaponry.
For the best in the business, come to Casa.
Thank you for shopping at Casa Fabrication Weaponry.
Surprised this place can still get supplies for a menu like this.
Maybe it's better if we don't ask how, or where.
I'm glad we're taking the time to do this. I could use a sanity check.
Things have been pretty crazy.
You know, my life flashed in front of my eyes on Mars. And there weren't enough moments like this with people I care about.
How are you feeling these days?
Feeling up to whatever the Reapers throw at me. and grateful that I convinced you to sit down for half a second and relax.
Let's talk. What are you drinking?
If you're trying to butter me up, it might take a nice steak sandwich, too.
So?
Shot of whiskey and a good old Canadian lager. Think they have it?
More likely to have Batarian shard wine.
At my parents' place in Vancouver, drank more than a few beers on their balcony, looking over English Bay. Yeah. Beautiful view. You know what, though? I feel good about our chances.
Yeah?
Yeah. Lets me sleep better at night.
You not sleeping, Caden?
Maybe a little restless. Look, we didn't come here to talk about work.
Here's to that.
Let me tell you something that I've been thinking about.
Okay.
I'm not the kind of guy who's the life of the party, who has a lot of friends.
Really?
No, it's true. I mean, some people even find my, integrity annoying.
Really?
No, seriously, I've... Okay, fine. Well, now you're messing with me. Okay, look. I just want you to know that I consider you a friend. Okay? A good one. Damn, this is way less awkward in my mind. Mostly, I guess I just wanted you to know that I admire you as a commander, and I value your friendship.
You're my brother, Caden.
I'm glad to be part of the crew.
What'd you call it? A sanity check?
Sanity check.
Knowles, this is Shepard. I found one of the code locations.
Okay, I'll shut it down. Just need to authorize your Spectre status. Looks like someone was trying to requisition medical supplies. Okay, that access code is officially disabled. Can you find any more?
So I'm in the shower with hot water and everything. And that's when Neaira came.
Neaira was another huntress on your ship?
Yeah, a friend. I wanted it to be more than that, but she had a medical condition.
It's okay. It's in the file.
The farm girl calls in to me that another Asari is here. I thought the shuttle had gotten back early. I come out in a towel, and Neaira walks through the door. But it wasn't her. Not anymore.
Spectre status recognized. Please select a destination. One moment, please. Now arriving at Presidium Commons. One moment, please. Now arriving at ward level Purgatory.
Will your new heavy armor keep you safe? I've watched reports on some of the things you find.
Well, we stop and read.
Hey, Commander! I was just about to get us another round.
So, looks like you two are having fun.
Yes. Joker has been smiling and laughing at a significantly higher rate since he and I agreed upon a relationship. I mean, he is happier.
It seemed like you two might make a good match.
I was not so certain. When I first presented this body to Jeff, he seemed aloof.
Really? What did Joker say?
He said I didn't have to conform to some feminine ideal in order to impress him. I then called him on his bullshit, and we then proceeded to talk normally. After your encouragement, his attitude exhibited signs of change. He said he was reluctant, but you convinced him to go for it.
I might have helped a little.
I see. Thank you for your support, Shepard. This is proving to be an illuminating experience. You just introduced me as your personal assistant's mech.
Yeah, well, it was the only way to get you inside.
But you know I am not one. Why deceive others?
You don't really want to introduce yourself as an AI with Reaper-based code. They would lynch you.
That would be an inefficient way to render me non-functional. Your turn. Counselor Tavos.
Hot, but points off for attitude.
Shaira the consort.
Hot, I guess? Can we stop this? You're creeping me out.
Dalatras Linron.
Ew.
Your turn. Counselor Tavos.
Hot, but points off for attitude.
Shaira the consort.
Status recognized. Please select a destination. One moment, please.
Landing the Parnithus system within striking distance of Thessia.
Now arriving at Presidium Embassy. One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay E24, Emergency Civilian Housing. One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay D-24.
Shepard, if you're feeling up to it, I thought we could do something fun for a change.
Have you discovered a way to let FTL stations without a war private to lobby?
No, ma'am.
Then consider this a serious assignment. Intel's expecting a Cerberus raid.
Cerberus? Cerberus?
They're a problem?
I thought we were fighting Reapers, ma'am.
Give it a week. You could be.
Not Rex stated that his support of the Turians proves that the Krogan are ready to return to the Citadel.
Knowles, I found another spot where the Batarian codes were used.
Looks like they were tampering with emergency food requests at the refugee center.
Trying to get more food for themselves?
Looks like. Okay. This code's offline now as well. Should just be one left, Commander.
I recovered Prothean data drives from Garbug. I'll have them brought here.
Commander Shepard. Thank you. I'm sure that'll help with any operation we have going. Thank you again, Commander. I appreciate the assist.
Just let me know when you're ready to take a break. Shepard, glad you came.
What'd you have in mind?
Something that doesn't involve fighting Reapers.
I don't think they've conquered the bar yet.
I already scoped it out. But then I thought, if this was my last day alive, I'd actually like to remember it.
So?
So, I had an idea.
Where are we going?
Somewhere we're not supposed to.
Now you're talking.
Ever have that one thing you always wanted to do before you died, Shepard?
I've woken up with a Turian next to me.
Still trying to make me blush, huh?
Until it works. So what's your one thing?
The whole time I worked at CSEC, I'd stare up at the top of the Presidium and say to myself, I want to go up there. But I never did. There were 137 regulations telling me I couldn't.
So you got them changed?
No. Now I just don't give a damn. Figured it's time to do something stupid just for the hell of it. Might be the last chance we ever get.
It's incredible.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't hope it would inspire a certain mood.
Something on your mind?
It seemed like you needed time to figure us out. Are you ready to be a one Turian kind of woman?
The only thing that made leaving Earth bearable was knowing you were out there somewhere.
I felt the same way. The worst part about the galaxy going to hell would have been never getting to see you again.
Well, here I am. Exactly where I want to be. I love you, Garrus Vakarian.
Wow. The vids Joker gave me, well, they never got this far. There was the part about sleeping together, but this is... I don't know exactly what...
Who needs a vid when you've got me?
Now, before we head back, there is one thing we're going to settle. Once and for all. I'm not saying you don't know how to handle a gun, just saying some of us know how to make it dance. So, let's find out who's really the best shot.
There are a few people in the galaxy who've seen me in action, Garrus. They seemed impressed.
Yeah, but I've actually seen you dance, Shepard. No comment.
All right, Vakarian, you're going down.
And don't worry, I loaded it with practice lugs for when you miss. That was an easy one. Let you build up your confidence. Long range, I wrote the book. Nobody alive can do this, not even Commander Shepard. Give me a tough one. I said a tough one.
Step aside. Do it.
I'm Garrus Vakarian, and this is now my favorite spot on the Citadel.
It's windy up here.
There, there. It's okay. I know there are other things you're good at.
Recognized. Please select a destination. One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay E-24, emergency civilian housing.
Turian State Arms. Your purchases are accredited to Hegemony.
James?
Commander, what brings you down here?
I was about to ask you that.
Well, after our little chat, I made up my mind. I'm going to join the N7 program.
And you're celebrating by getting a tattoo?
Sort of. See, there's no official channels to go through right now. So, I guess this is my way of making it official. Technically, I'm just an N7 recruit, but, you know, I figure with you as my training officer, how could I fail? right?
I'm flattered, but I wouldn't exactly say I'm training you.
Not officially, but what the hell is in this goddamn war? I'm just saying, whether you like it or not, you're my direct superior and you're N7. So I take my lead from you. And you know, I'll take whatever advice you got.
Really?
Sure. The good advice.
Well, they wouldn't ask you if they didn't think you could handle it.
Here's hoping.
But the real work starts now.
Uh-huh. I know it seems like I don't take things seriously, but when I commit to something, I fully commit.
Clearly.
Hey, I won't let you down.
The only person you need to prove yourself to is the one standing in the mirror every morning.
Good point.
You know, that's gonna sting for a few days. You gonna be ready for duty?
Always. Hey, maybe we should get matching.
You want me to get an N7 tattoo?
N7? Sure. Or you could get my name done. Somewhere special.
You're such a tease, Vega.
Who, me?
You ever gonna make good on all this flirting?
I was just...
That's what I thought. Later, Lieutenant.
Later. Careful!
I recognize you. You're Commander Shepard.
And you must be Tactus. Heard the refugees consider you their leader.
Yes. Someone needs to sort out this mess. CSEC has tightened access to the Citadel, and we've got desperate people down here with no place to go.
I also hear you need basic medical supplies. Dr. Chakwis spoke of a mutually beneficial trade.
I tried to be clear. In my experience, the Alliance looks out for their own. Trust is a hard thing to come by these days. I know you need our military supplies, but they're worth far more than your basic meds. Her offer wasn't satisfactory.
Your people need our supplies, and my people need every edge we can get. Your combat-grade meds will make a difference. And our mission may just save everyone. Now's not the time for pettiness or mistrust.
With our day-to-day worries, it's easy to forget we are all in this together. I'll have my people contact yours. You'll have your supplies as soon as possible.
I heard about the horrible things Cerberus did during the coup. That's not the organization I joined. I've heard so many sad stories. These people have lost so much. I've heard so many sad stories. These people have lost so much.
Knowles, I found another point where someone was using the Batarian access codes.
Shepard, they're using it right now. I can trace them.
Where are they?
Right there in the refugee camp. I'm on my way.
Here's our culprit, Shepard. Thanks for your help.
Shepard? Of course. After what you did to the Bahawk system, why would I expect anyone else?
Do I know you?
No. But you knew Commander Balak, our greatest agent. When you killed him in the sky over Terra Nova, you threw our external operations into chaos. The Reapers annihilated us, and most of our people have been transformed into monstrosities. A few remaining warships have resorted to petty piracy, while I steal scraps for refugees.
Why are you wasting time with this? You could be fighting the Reapers alongside us.
You expect us to join forces with the Alliance?
You've lost Karshan, and we've lost Earth. We can die on our own or fight together. Knowles, you disabled the codes?
Yes, Commander.
Good. I'm dropping all charges, Spectre Authority. You're free to go.
I'll talk to my people.
You think the Batarians will work with us? We'll find out.
Spectre status recognized. Please select a destination.
One moment, please.
Now arriving at Presidium Embassy.
Hell of a view, isn't it?
During our war, this place became a myth to my people. A dream glimpsed only in the memory shards. The Citadel was both the heart of our civilization and its demise.
The Reapers hit here first, didn't they?
No one I knew had ever seen the Citadel. To be here now, I don't know what to think.
It might not seem like much, but a Prothean is standing on the Citadel alive. That's a victory in itself.
Perhaps. When things were at their darkest, we used to tell stories, imagining the wonders of this place. The seat of our empire. The power to sway worlds. The galaxy belonged to us.
Nowadays, a lot of races have embassies here.
It's true, then. You share power with the rest?
It's not perfect, but it's kept the peace. Most of the time.
Pardon me. This one has been listening. This one suspects you are a Prothean.
Ehanna, I remember your kind when you were still minnows in the ocean.
This one is unworthy. This one has seen the face of an enkindler.
They consider your kind to be their gods.
A pity we did not teach them to speak better.
You're really a Prothean?
I am.
But if you lost the last war, what hope do we have?
For many, there may be no hope. The Reapers killed trillions in my cycle. The odds of being among the living...
I don't think that's gonna work.
But you are still alive now. That alone is a miracle. And you still have the power to fight. My people knew your kind when you were young. Turian, Asari, Hanna, there was potential in all of you. Now you must seize that potential and become the weapon you are meant to be. The weapon that tells the Reapers we are not machines. We are alive, and we will fight back.
Thank you. That meant a lot. Commander Shepard, it must be an honor to have a Prothean fighting alongside you.
He's starting to learn his way around. Javik is one of the best soldiers I've ever seen.
The Commander is a capable warrior as well, for a human who once lived in caves. Thank you, Commander. I've enjoyed my time here, walking among the young. I will see you back on the Normandy.
Heavy losses are mounting as human colonies resume to dream.
So many pieces to put back together since the Cerberus attack. We're reeling from the implications. Udina in league with Cerberus trying to murder the Council. These are dark days for all of us.
Thought you'd be in the hospital.
If I'm breathing, I'm working. Probably the worst I've ever been hurt. Fitting, I guess, given the state of the galaxy. But if Cerberus thinks a few slugs is gonna keep me out of action, they've got another thing coming.
Can this station be defended?
The internal security breaches have been patched, but we're dangerously low on manpower. We're grilling our own people and trying to figure out if Udina acted alone, but it's time-consuming. All in all, we're still vulnerable, but I think we've taken the right steps.
All that time you were working for Udina, did you ever suspect?
Always rubbed me a little wrong. Still, that traitorous bastard upped me. Probably made me for an idiot. I guess I proved him right.
He's dead and you're still here, Bailey.
Thanks to you. If you hadn't shown up, Udina and Cerberus would be dancing on my grave.
How does the Citadel fit into the war now?
The war finally found us. This is so far beyond our imagination, and we have been trained to expect the unexpected. Since the coup attempt, folks are shutting down and shutting in. I hear a lot of praying. And crying. They're saying this is the war to end all wars. Well, I haven't seen anything to say they aren't right.
You hear anything about your family out there?
Not a peep. I always believed I'd get a chance to tell my ex-wife a few things. And my kids on Earth. I was supposed to visit them. First vacation in years, but I had to cancel when I got promoted.
Don't give up hope, Bailey.
Thanks, Shepard. I'm really trying not to think about it.
I'll leave you to it, then.
I'm here if you need me.
You're all right, Shepard.
Miranda, what's going on?
Couldn't meet in person. The Citadel is too dangerous right now. I heard about the attempted coup.
Yeah, with Kai Lang's help, Udina nearly seized control.
Kai Lang? That slippery bastard still alive?
He's alive and right in the middle of all this.
That complicates things. I'll be on my guard. Look, I don't have much time, but I learned what happened to my sister.
Where is she?
I don't know that yet, but my father was definitely responsible. If he's done anything to her, I'll kill him.
Miranda.
Shepard, listen. I'm being hunted by Cerberus assassins, a lot of them. I need to stay out of sight.
What? Why?
I heard a rumor, maybe more, that my father is working on something for the elusive man. Something big.
Why would your father be working with the elusive man? Especially now.
My father is ruthless about preserving his legacy.
Legacy?
He has an obsession with making his mark in history, ensuring his dynasty lasts forever.
And you think the elusive man made him an offer?
Exactly.
Whatever's going on with your father can't be good. We have to figure this out.
I agree, but I need to do this myself. It's time I stopped running from him.
You're sure?
Yes. I can't think straight until I know Ari is safe.
Be careful.
I can't promise that, Shepard. Could you?
No. I couldn't. Was the Volus ambassador here earlier?
Yes, he was, Commander.
I need in. Spectre business.
I'll unlock the office when you're ready.
been this uncooperative with us before, Ambassador.
That's because you were actually doing some good in the galaxy before.
Has that changed? How many colonies would be gone if we hadn't taken action against the Collectors?
Too many. But fighting the Alliance...
must continue in order to end the war. We understand it took a lot for you to reach out to Cerberus, Ambassador Korlak. We ask that you trust us a little longer.
You people are monsters!
Ambassador, please.
Hundreds dead. Udina betraying the Council. I should have cut ties with you ages ago.
And what will that accomplish now? The risks you took by passing information to Cerberus, it's left you in an interesting position. If you sever contact, we can't protect you from the consequences.
I don't. I have no time for this.
We'll speak again. Have a good day, Ambassador Korlak.
The Turians think I'm still working for Cerberus. They've put a price on my head. I can't go to CSEC, but Cerberus has plans. An entire Turian colony rests on my life. If anyone finds this, I hid a tracking receiver in the office suite beside the human embassies.
Until we killed Korlak.
Once the credits go through, was beginning to think you weren't interested in the money.
I'm not. Because Korlak worked for Cerberus? What'd they do to you? None of your goddamn business. He waking up?
This is Commander Shepard. Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes, I can hear you.
Tell me where you are.
Presidium. CSEC will check Selkish arms when they realize I'm missing.
They won't give a damn when they realize you sold them out to Cerberus.
Wait. Cerberus is planning to attack a colony that...
Stay calm. Help's coming.
Now arrive.
Zaid used to work for Cerberus.
Zaid.
How you know my name all of a sudden?
Good question.
Damn, wrong door. He needs you alive to stop Cerberus.
Cerberus is after a Turian colony. Kill me, and they get it.
Drop my name.
Shepard's investigating. She's a recent acquaintance.
How recent?
Very.
Shit. All right, I'm listening.
Been a while, Zaid.
Shepard. Glad I wasn't just making an ass of myself over a hunch. Undisciplined bastards. This is what I get for signing up at the last minute.
Where's Korlak?
I'm here, Commander. You saved my life. I almost died because the Turians thought I was still with Cerberus.
Did those marks hurt you?
I'm fine. They wanted me alive until the fees were delivered for my capture. They didn't care about what I had to say.
You kept mentioning a colony in your message.
Information on a Turian planet's defense system. They'll strike soon. But if I tell you which planet they're attacking, Cerberus will know I turned traitor.
Turn? You already betrayed your own people.
We saved your life. Tell us what planet you put in danger.
I can offer a bargain. The Volus bombing fleet. In tactical terms, it's worth far more than a colony.
Or you could give us both.
You can warn the Turians there'll be an attack, Commander. That should be general enough to ward off suspicion.
You tried to do the right thing before. It failed because you trusted the wrong people. Now here's your chance to make up for it. You're giving us Volus support, and you're going to help us make Cerberus pay for using you.
I can't.
You can.
Waste of everyone's time trying to appeal to a Volus's better nature, Shepard.
Aphis. The colony's name is Aphis. Cerberus wants its shipyards.
And the bombing fleet?
Yes, it's yours, Commander. I'll speak with Citadel Security about this incident. You have my thanks.
Took him long enough to spit that out.
Zaid, what are you doing here?
Later. C6 on their way. Won't be too pleased with the mess we left them. Catch up with me at the docks if you like. What the hell are you looking at?
Nothing. Nothing.
Wondered if you'd show up, Shepard. Figured you'd be too busy recruiting goddamn armies for this war you're in charge of. I'll bet. I've seen footage of what happened on Earth. Tell you what. I'll see if some old contacts of mine are still around. Can't promise you anything, but if enough of them are still breathing, I can lend a hand.
Who are those people you were with?
Bunch of mercs from Omega. Signed on with them when I heard they were making a hit on Cerberus. Should have studied the job longer.
Who are those people you were with?
Bunch of mercs from Omega. Signed on with them when I heard they were making a hit on Cerberus.
Spectre status, ready. One moment. Now arriving at docking bay D-24.
I'd like to request a transfer to a zone with Reaper, Sergeant.
And may I ask why you think your deployment deserves special treatment, Private?
I think I'll do better against the Reapers than Cerberus, ma'am.
And what combat experience against Reapers are you basing this on?
None, ma'am.
Outstanding.